I'll go into my layout templates, and I have them, as you can see, saved for different elements here. I put them into folders because of the backup file. It's just easier for me to read. You don't necessarily have to have separate folders for each one, but you can see when you open up each one, you get a backup file, and sometimes, depending on how you have that listed, it could be a little confusing. So if I open up the floor plan file, you'll see here it's a basic file that has the title block as a blank, ready to be prepared title block. The sheets are indexed and set for automatic numbering, so as you add additional sheets or additional drawings, if it's a smaller set of floor plans, maybe multiple floors on a single sheet, you can you don't have to worry about what that sheet number is each time. But these are set up as very simple files. Again, the layering system on here is just the layering systems that I would typically use and set in the hierarchy in which you want to see them visible, with the top being the grid lines that I would have, the room names, floor plan notes, dimensions, plan line work, SketchUp model, and then title block at the bottom. So a very simple layout, very easy to identify and control what you have shown on that layout sheet. I do this for all different file types. So if I go back a step in here, you can see them. As I have them for the elevations. I have them for odd sheets like data sheets that show all the code requirements and sheet index, things like that, interior elevation sheets, and so on, for a complete set of construction documents. I've also often been asked, why don't I just do one layout file with the entire set? I specifically don't do that because I have a lot of sheets in a given set, anywhere between 30 and 60 sheets. And to me, it's just easier to manage and focus on a specific scope of work when I have one specific file type open.